Only on Fox 6 tonight, an artist's goal, of course, is to be seen. And one Wisconsin native, well, he has achieved that goal many times over in 2013.
He's the one who did the cover of Time magazine when, of course, they named Pope Francis as their man of the year. Fox 6's Mike Lowe reports he's got a gift for faces, and he actually honed it while riding the Red Line in Chicago.
Stormy, husky, brawling. City of big shoulders. Poet Carl Sandburg on Chicago. Maybe true from a distance, but up close, street level, it's not the shoulders that strike you.
You know, I can understand with broad shoulders, but it's definitely the faces of Chicago that make the city what it is.
It's the faces.
Happy New Year. Happy New Year, folks.
They show a city's generosity.
Thank you very much.
It's agony.
Pain. Like a girl who smiles a lot, but she has so much pain.
It's relief and it's relationships.
I have more of a Middle Eastern look than a typical American look.
Beard, brown eyes, defined chin.
There's always like some kind of character that's brought out by each and every face.
Yeah, I'm a little bit obsessed with people. The other thing is...
Meet Jason Seiler.
I would say I'm pretty much addicted to it.
He's an artist who draws his inspiration from the city.
Hop on the Red Line.
And its faces.
And just sketch people. And I've done that a lot. It's a lot of fun, especially in the city. There's so many characters. There's so many weird people, interesting people.
Born in Green Bay, raised in Rice Lake and Eau Claire, Seiler always wanted to draw and dreamed of having his work seen all over the world. Maybe even on the cover of a magazine.
There was times that my father grounded me when I was a kid because I drew too much. He took me to the movie theater one time and I was drawing in the movie theater instead of watching a movie, and he's like, oh, you got problems.
But it was clear he had a gift, not just for drawing people, but for drawing something out of them.
Having a life in your work. And to me, the trick is the eyes and expression, even just the subtle things. When someone smiles, their eyes smile.
His artwork appearing in the New York Times, the Wall Street Journal, and Rolling Stone.
For Rolling Stone, I've never had more than 2 days to do a painting for them.
Because of shrinking deadlines in a now world, he's on the forefront of an artistic transition.
You know, some people get confused and they think, oh, you're just pushing some buttons. It's not at all like that.
His canvas is now a computer.
I have created my own brushes. You still have to draw it. You still have to mix your color and paint. And what I work on digitally is I have a screen that's pressure sensitive. So I make a palette just like I would with oils. I do underpaintings just like I would with oils. And I just build up texture and layers. And
the stylus mimics different brushes. Soon he would have the brush with fame he always dreamed of. Seiler received a call from Time magazine to paint Edward Snowden, the government contractor who leaked classified national security secrets.
I wanted to make him look like a cool spy, like something from Bourne Identity or something. So I just dressed myself that way and took pictures, and then I drew him attached to me, sort of a thing. And so
Time's editors were so impressed with the Snowden piece.
This is the area that I made up.
They called again and asked for another portrait.
They wanted very calm, peaceful smile. They wanted to capture his humbleness, these edges.
The magazine requested a picture of a person whose humility and holiness have captivated the world. The Pope.
They gave me a very specific type of expression that they were looking for.
Seiler went to work.
It looks really chaotic.
For 70 hours.
What I was still trying to get right is the mouth.
He labored on what would become Time magazine's Person of the Year cover.
To me, this is like winning an Academy Award. As a kid, I would go to a bookstore, flip open Rolling Stone, and look at the art, and just dream one day, I know I can do this, you know? And so to actually be doing it, you know, I never take it for granted.
For Seiler, in a city of shoulders, it's always been faces. And now the world sees those faces as he does.
I can never get bored of drawing people.
In Chicago, Mike Lowe, Fox 6 News.
It is interesting because Snowden was actually the runner-up for Person of the Year, so this artist actually painted really two of the most widely seen images
indeed
this year, or the two people,
and
for sure.
And those are the two people talked about as possible.
Exactly.